Sobabiscum. Oremus, exaudi nos Domine Sancte Pater Omnipotens et Tenedius, et mitere digniae Sanctum Angeum Tuum deceris, et custodiat, foveat, protegat, visitat, et quod defendat omnes habitantes in hoc habitaculo, per Christum Dominum nostrum. Patris, et Filii, et Spiritus Sancti. Amen. In tribo d'altere Dei. Iudice Medius, Adicione, Caos, Damien, Degente, Non Sancta, Amni, Nico, Doroso, Eru, Eme. Emitero cem tuam, et veritatem tuam, ipsum et deduxunt, et adduxunt, in montem sanctum tuum, et in tabernacula tua. Concita vati vincita, Deus, Deus meus, quae tristes anima mea curae conturbas me. Gloria Patri et Filio Spiritui Sancto. In tribo d'altare Dei. Aditam nostrum in nomine Domini. Confiter de omnipotenti, Beate Maria, Sempe Virgini, Beate Michele, Congelo, Beate Ioanni, Battiste, Sanctis Apostolis, Petro et Paolo, Omnibus, Sanctis Aris Apes, Cave Cavinimis, Cognitas Unie Verbo et Opere, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa, Ideo Paco, Beate Maria, Sempe Virgini, Beate Michele, Maxangelo, Beate Ioanni, Battista, Sanctus Apostolis, Petro et Paolo, Omnibus, Sanctus Aris Apes, Oare, Promea Dominium Deum Nostrum. Amen. Exato vest omnipotens Deus et dimissis peccatis justus producat vos vitam aeternam. In urgentiam solutionem et remissionem peccatorum nostrorum, privat nobis omnipotens et misericors dominus. Deus te conversus deificabis nos. Nos teneris domine misericordiam tuam. Domine ex adios funem meam. Dominus obiscum. Oremus. Misericordiae tuam Domine et misericordiae tuae quae saeculos sunt, nunquam Domine tuum abis inimici nostri, libera nos Deus Israel ex omnibus angustiis nostris. A te Domine eleva via anima meam, Deus meus in te confido donne rubescam. Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Reminiscere misericordiae tuam Domine et misericordiae tuae quae saeculos sunt, nunquam Domine tuum abis inimici nostri, libera nos Deus Israel ex omnibus angustiis nostris. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison. Christe eleison. Kyrie eleison. Kyrie eleison.
Christe,
Domino Savaviscum. Oremus. Deus qui conspicis omni nos virtute destitui, interius exterius qui custodi, ut ab omnibus adversitatibus muniamur in corpore et a pravis cogitationis mundemur in mente. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui te convit et regnat unitate Spiritus Sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Lex epistolae beati Pauli apostoli a Thessalonicenses. Fratres, rogamus vos et obsecramus in Domino Iesu, ut quem ad modum accepistis anobis, commodo porteat vos ambulare et placere Deo, sic et ambuletis abundetis magis. Citis enimque preceptae derim vobis per Dominum Iesum, ec est enim voluntas Dei sanctificatio vestra, ut abstineatis vos a fornicatione, ut fiat unus quisque vestrum vasum possidere in sanctificatione et honore, non in passione desideri, sic ut et gentes quae ignorant Deum, ne et ne quis super gradiatur, neque circumveniat in negotio fratrem suum. Quoniam vindex est Dominus Deis omnibus, sicut prediximus vobis et testificatis sumus. Non en invocavit nos Deus in immunditiam, sed in sanctificationem, in Christo Iesu Domino nostro. Tribulationes cordis mei dilatate sunt de necessitatibus ministeri pe me Domine, et divinitate mea et labora meum et dimite omnia peccata mea, confite mi Domino coniam bonus, coniam in secolum misericordia ius. Christo qui tu potentiam Domini, auditas faces omnes soles ius. Beati qui custodiam judicium et facem justitiam in omni tempore. Memento nostri Domine bene placito populi tui, visita nos in salutari tuo.
Oh.
Sequentia Sancti Evangelii secundum Matteum. In illo tempore assumpsit Iesus Petrum et Iacobum et Ioannem fratrem eius, et uxit illos in montem excessum seorsum, et transfiguratus est ante eos, et resplenduit facies eius sicut sol, vestimenta autem eius facta sunt alba sicut nix, et ecce apparuerunt illis Moises et Elias cum eloquentes. Respondens autem Petrus dixit ad Iesum, Domine, bonum est, noc hic esse, civis faciamus ic tria tabernacula, tibi unum, Moisi unum, et Elie unum. Aduce oroquente et in nubes lucida obum bravit eos. Et ecce vox de nube dicens, hic est filius meus directus, in quo mihi bene complacui ipsum audite. Et audientes discipulis cecidunt in faciem suam, et timuerunt valde. Et accessit Iesus, et titigit eos dixit queis, surgite et nuite timere. Levantes otem oculos suos neminem viderunt, nisi solum Iesum. Et descendentibus iris de monte precipitis Iesus dicens, nemine dixeritis visionem, donec filius hominis a mortuis resurgat. The epistle is taken from the first letter of St. Paul, the Apostle, to the Thessalonians. Brethren, we pray and beseech you in the Lord Jesus, that as you have received from us how you ought to walk and to please God, so also you would walk, that you may abound the more. For you know what precepts I have given to you by the Lord Jesus. For this is the will of God, your sanctification, that you should abstain from fornication, that every one of you should know how to possess his vessel in sanctification and honor, not in the passion of lust, like the Gentiles that know not God, and that no man overreach nor circumvents his brother in business, because the Lord is the avenger of all these things, as we have told you before and have testified. For God has not called us into uncleanness, but into sanctification in Christ Jesus our Lord. Continuation of the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. At that time, Jesus took Peter and James and John, his brother, and bringeth them up into a high mountain apart. And he was transfigured before them, and his face did shine as the sun, and his garments became white as the snow. And behold, there appeared to them Moses and Elias talking with him. And Peter answering said to Jesus, Lord, it is good for us to be here. If thou wilt, let us make here three tabernacles, one for thee, and one for Moses, and one for Elias. And as he was yet speaking, behold, a bright cloud overshadowed them. And lo, a voice out of the cloud, saying, This is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Hear you him. And the disciples, hearing, fell upon their face and were very much afraid. And Jesus came and touched them and said to them, Arise and fear not. And they, lifting up their eyes, so no one but only Jesus. And as they came down from the mountain, Jesus charged them, saying, Tell the vision to no man till the Son of Man be risen from the dead. Dear faithful, you have the announcements for this week in your bulletin. And also you will find at the back of the church, some copies of the letter of Father Pagliarani, the Superior General of the Society St. Pius X. And I do recommend you to read this beautiful letter. You find it also on internet. It's a beautiful letter of our Superior General. Read this letter. Regarding the announcements, I just want to focus a few things. Today, we have the march against abortion, the 40 Days for Life in Wellington. I think this is why you are less numerous this morning, because some have been there, and I think the girls went there. So the first pews are not reserved this morning, and though if you are a bit lacking of seats in the back, you can come up and take these pews. And there will be also Sunday 29th of March, so there will be a second Sunday also. The Legion of Mary will have its annual ceremony, ACS, on the 22nd of March, 5 p.m., half an hour before benediction on that Sunday. It will include the renewal of the consecration to Our Lady according to Saint Louis Marie Grignion de Montfort. And so I invite all the faithful who have made this beautiful consecration to Our Lady to come and to renew their consecration. It's a good thing to renew it annually, and it's a good occasion to do it all together at the occasion of the ACS of the Legion of Mary. And also regarding the Legion of Mary, among you we have auxiliaries. They do not take part in the apostolate of the Legion of Mary, however, they pray, so they do take part somehow through their prayers. And so it's good to be auxiliaries of the Legion of Mary. It is a promise of a few prayers to say. And the legionaries would like to update the list of auxiliaries. So if you are one and say your prayers for the Legion, please contact them at the email of the Legion of Mary, which is given in the bulletin. And of course, new auxiliaries are always welcome. If you would like to, you're interested in the apostolate of the Legion of Mary and you cannot take part for some reasons, you are busy, you are working, etc., you don't have the time to give, but you can give your prayers and then you can become an auxiliaries. And it does help, you know, because the prayers, that's what makes the work of the Legion efficient. One more thing about the retreats, because it's coming soon. This year the retreats are sooner than usual. It will be after Easter. As you know, it just has been announced already. So the women first, the octave of Easter, the week right after Easter, and then for the men, it will be a special retreat in fact, because your priests will be attending themselves the retreat, preached by Father Albert, the Dominican priest, will be the one to preach the retreat for men and priests. And so, if you want, it will not be an Ignatian retreat for men, it will be a Dominican retreat. If you want to join that retreat, it will be certainly a grace, and you are welcome. So these two retreats, men with Father Albert, second week, and first week for the women, and we need a cook for the women's retreat. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen. Dear faithful,
Today's gospel may seem a bit strange during this holy season of Lent. We might have expected to hear about our Lord's passion and his sufferings. And in fact, we will. We will soon, very soon, follow our Lord during his sufferings. But for now, we hear that our Lord Jesus Christ manifested his glory to three of his apostles, Peter, James, and John. Our Lord will to do so precisely just ahead of his passion, because he wanted these apostles to, he wanted to preserve them from being offended at his sufferings, at his weakness during his agony. These three apostles will be the ones who will be at the Garden of Olives in Gethsemane during the agony of our Lord Jesus Christ. So he wanted them to understand beforehand that he is truly God, that he is hiding his deity beneath the veil of the flesh, and that he who could communicate so great a glory to his body would also be able to rescue that body from death if he so willed. So this is the reason our Lord wanted to strengthen Peter, James, and John in their faith before the great trial of his sufferings. And he wanted to strengthen their virtues so that they will be able to attend this passion of our Lord, his crucifixion. So he wanted them first to taste the joys of his glory. Saint Peter, in his joy and felicity to see the glory of our Lord, he said, "Lord, it is good for us to be here." Forgetting everything in the world, he had only one wish: to remain always upon the mountain near his transfigured Savior. For us, dear faithful, there is also a way to make it good to be here below. And if we enjoy that, we will be able to undergo the trials of this life easily. How will we have this kind of heaven on earth? Saint Augustine says, "The joy of a good conscience is a paradise." The joy of a good conscience is a paradise. Yes, dear faithful, we may have a heaven upon earth if we have a good conscience. A good conscience gives us joy, facilitates our labors and comforts in trials and sufferings. How joyful are the children, little children, when they are playing and amusing themselves? Why? How come they are so merry, these children? Because they are innocent. Because they have not yet drunk of the bitter chalice of sin. Saint Chrysostom says, "He who has a good conscience is in the most oppressing circumstances much happier and more content than others who are deprived of this good in the midst of riches." What a treasure, what a treasure. We can admire Job, the old man Job, in his trials. He loses his flocks. A storm demolishes his houses and burns his sons and daughters amidst their ruins. He is reduced from abundance to the most abject poverty. He is covered with leprosy, derided and calumniated by his own wife. Yet he remains patient and resigned to God in all his vicissitudes. He did not fear death. He looked cheerfully into eternity, for faith told him that good awaits him there, much more precious than the world can give. So, though he lost all, he saved one thing, a good conscience. And it was this that supported him in his extreme adversity, in his extreme abandonment. A good conscience. Well, dear faithful, we build our good conscience by the charity, the acts of charity that we make, the works of mercy, especially during this Lent, as we are invited really to do so. And also by the sacrament of penance, which cleanses us from our past sins and clears and restores this good conscience. Precisely, the very first words of this Mass today, in this second Sunday in Lent, are, "Remember, O Lord, thy bowels of compassion and thy mercies that are from the beginning of the world." So, dear faithful, each time we need to retrieve a good conscience, we shall have recourse to the compassion and mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ. The forgiveness of our sins. This is an incomparable gift that can render our soul similar to our Lord transfigured, shining as the sun, as white as snow. If your sins be as scarlet, they shall be made as white as snow. And if they be red as crimson, they shall be white as wool. What a grace, dear faithful, what a grace to receive. And it can be obtained only in the Catholic Church. The very moment our Savior said to us, "Thy sins are forgiven thee," we are no longer a slave of Satan, but a child of God. We possess that inestimable treasure, sanctifying grace, with a claim to the eternal happiness of heaven, the joy here below of a good conscience. There is no such profitable time as a Lent season, dear faithful, to do a good confession. Make a good confession. Why not having even complete confession of your life? You do that not 5 minutes before the Mass starts, but you come in during the week and you do that. You receive the ashes. It's a sacramental. It gives you strength to do penance during Lent, and it also gives you this ability to be sorry for your sins. So yes, there is a necessity to have recourse to the sacrament of penance. There is no sin which God cannot or will not forgive to anyone who sincerely repents having recourse to the sacrament of penance. We shall go there very secure. Remember, a good confession is what delights heaven more than the creation of the whole universe. And because Lent is a time to do a good confession, allow me to speak a little about the principal requisites for a good confession. What is the most important disposition to bring to confession? Contrition, dear faithful. Chiefly contrition. What is contrition? The Council of Trent defines contrition as a grief of the soul for the sins committed, the detestation of the sins committed with the intention not to sin in future. So you see, it is this interior sorrow with a detestation of the sins committed. And of all the parts which belong to the sacraments of penance, contrition is the most necessary. It is a matter of the sacrament, like water for baptism. If one would baptize, say the word, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost, and would not pour the water, there will be no baptism. Of course. Well, that seems obvious. But the same things for the sacrament of penance. Someone will not bring contrition, the grief, the sorrow for having offended God. There is no absolution. The priest can say the words, nothing is happening. Neither mortal nor venial sin would be forgiven. The sacrament will be useless. No sinner has ever yet received the forgiveness of his sins without true contrition. Even the priest has to judge about the contrition of the penitent and cannot give absolution if he encounters no contrition in the sinner. It's even more important than the confession itself, the saying of your sins. A priest can give absolution without, in some cases, you know, if someone cannot speak, it happens with some people who are sick, cannot even speak, but the priest makes sure that the penitent is sorry for his sins, some signs, he can give absolution absolutely, even without any confession even. But the priest cannot give absolution if there is no contrition. If someone refuses to bore it to regret his sins, he is unworthy of absolution. What a precious grace to implore the faithful, if we want to make a good confession for Lent, this grace of contrition. Let's have a look quickly, if you allow me, dear faithful, about the qualities of contrition. That it may obtain for us the remission of sins, it shall be interior, universal, and supernatural. I'm going to explain. Interior. Obviously, contrition must be interior. It is a sorrow of the soul. Detestation of the sins committed. If we had only but external manifestation of kind of a, yes, detestation for sins, but externally only, by words only, saying the act of contrition, but from our mouth or lips only, it will be hypocrisy. It will not be a real contrition. Contrition must be interior because all sins proceeds from the heart. And in order to forgive our sins, God requires, before everything else, that our will, which had turned away from Him by our sins, should, by repenting of our sins, be turned to Him again. So it has to be in the will, in the heart. A sacrifice to God is an afflicted spirit, a contrite and humble heart. O God, thou wilt not despise. And God sees, of course, what is in our soul, in our heart. So it has to come from our heart. And universal means we must be sorry for all the mortal sins we have committed. You know that by your catechism, it's a reminder. Well, it's not possible that one grievous sin be remitted without the other. Because precisely as we turn ourselves away from God by every single mortal sin, we separate ourselves completely from God. Well, we need to repent from this movement. And this movement is done by one single mortal sin. We must be sorry for sin, otherwise our reconciliation with God cannot take place. Regarding venial sins, they only weaken, do not entirely destroy, sanctifying grace and the love of God. So we would receive the sacrament of penance validly and worthily, even if our sorrow is not on all of them. But contrition is such an essential part of the sacrament of penance that if a person has only venial sins to confess, he should be sorry for at least some of them. And lastly, supernatural. Our contrition is supernatural when we are sorry for our sins, not on account of their natural evil consequences, but from a supernatural motive, which when it refers to God, when it refers to the matters of faith, because of our sins we have offended God, because we have deserved hell. If it's only from a natural motive, because we have lost some goods, or because of shame, because sin is degrading, well, then this will be only natural motive, you see. And if such sorrow may bring us to a greater sorrow, it's good, but it will not be sufficient in itself to obtain the forgiveness of sins. The point is to have a hatred for our sins, to detest the sin because they have offended God, not only the temporal evils consequence of our sins. Once again, as long as our heart is not yet averted from evil, God cannot forgive us. This contrition can be perfect and imperfect. It's imperfect when we are sorry because of the punishments of sin, because we fear the punishments of hell. It is supernatural, it's a motive of faith, it's good, it's sufficient to receive the absolution of the priest, it's a good contrition, but it's imperfect. We call it attrition. It is not coming from a complete love. The complete love will be what we call the perfect contrition. It will be not only because of the punishments of hell, but because we are sorry for having offended God. This is the motive, the full motive, the perfect contrition, because we have offended God. Like children who are sorry for their wrongs because they are sorry they see the pain they've done to their parents doing their wrongs, and they are sorry for that purpose, not because they fear the punishment of their father. This ingratitude is of the against the Holy Trinity is the motive really of this perfect contrition. And you see, it's important to, if we try to make this good confession and to arouse in us this good contrition, to try to arouse our contrition as a perfect contrition, the most perfect possible contrition. The perfect contrition is so good and pleasing to God that it can obtain for us the forgiveness of our sins even without the sacrament of penance. It goes together with an earnest desire of the sacrament. It's only when we couldn't receive the sacrament without any fault of our part. But it's possible with a perfect contrition. We don't really know when we can have reached that perfect contrition, so it's more secure to go to confession. But it's possible. It's possible to reach that, absolution without the sacraments. The Council of Trent says so. Perfect contrition bestows the grace of justification on the mortal sinner even before the actual reception of the sacrament of penance. So it's only by perfect sorrow associated with the desire for the sacrament of penance. Whereas the imperfect contrition cleanses the soul from all sin, yes, but only in connection with the sacrament of penance. It will be only by the absolution of the priest. And in fact, it will be made perfect by the absolution of the priest. This is the kind of consecration that happens in this sacrament. There is a change of imperfect contrition to perfect contrition by the absolution of the priest. Well, dear faithful, let us pray and beg from God in order to obtain during this Lent the grace of a true contrition of our sins. If we do not see in us real changes in life after so many confessions, so many communions, so many lengths, it is because we lack of contrition. We need to excite ourselves the true sorrow for our sins to a real, internal, universal, supernatural, and even perfect contrition by the meditation of the Passion of our Lord Jesus Christ, especially by the Station of the Cross. Let us make a good confession during this Lent, and our good conscience will give us to enjoy the presence of God of His glory, to embrace all our life with all its trials generously, graciously, after our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Et in nonum Deum.
Patrem omnipotentem, factorem celi et terre visibile, omniot invisibile, et in omnia. Credo in nonum Deum, patrem omnipotentem, factorem celi et terre visibile, omniot invisibile, et in nonum Dominum Iesum Christum, filium Deum, genitum, ex patre natum ante omnia saecula. Deum de Deo, lumen de lumine Deum, verum de Deo, vero. Genitum non factus consubstantialem patri, perquem omnia factus sunt. Et propter nos homines et propter nostram salutem licitum de sus. et incarnatus est spiritus sancto ex Maria Virgine et homo factus est. Crucifixus est siam panabis supontio Pilate passus et sepultus est. Et resurrexit per sia diis et omnes scripturas. Et nunc serum sedet extram patris, et iterum venturus est cum gloria in caribus et mortuos, cuius regnina erit finis. Et in spiritus sanctum domino edificante in cui ex patre filio per possedit. Ficum patre et filio simon adoratur, cum glorificatur, quod opus est per prophetas. Et unam sanctam catholicam et apostolicam ecclesiam, confiteo ad unum baptistum in remission peccatorum et exsueto resurrectionem mortuorum et vitam venturi seculi. Amen.
Propter nos homines, et propter nostram salutem, descendit de celibis, caritus est, de Spiritus Sanctus, ex Maria Virgine, et homo factus est. Sepultus est, et resurrexit via die, secundum scripturas, et ascendit in celum, sedet ad exterram patris, et iterum venturus est cum gloria. Cae vivos et mortuos, cuius regninam erit finis, et in Spiritum Sanctum Dominum, et vivificantem, ex Patre Filio quae possedit, cum Patre et Filio simul adoratur, et cum glorificatur, in locutus est per prophetas, et unam sanctam catholicam et apostolicam ecclesiam confiteo unum baptisma in remissionem peccatorum et expecto resurrectionem mortuorum.
Dominus vobiscum. Oremus.
Meditabor in mandatis tuis, que dilexi vale, et eva humanus meas ad mandata tua, que dilexi. appendage.
Justum est ecum et salutare nos tibi semper et ubique gratias agere Domine Sancte Pater Omnipotens Eterne Deus qui corporali et unio vitia comprimis mentem et levas virtutem largiris et premiam Per Christum Dominum Nostrum, per quem maiestatem tuam laudant angeli, adorant dominationes, tremunt potestates, celicerumque virtutes ac beata seraphim, Socia exultatione concelebrant, cum quibus et nostras voces ut admitti iubeas deprecamur, supplici confessione dicentes.
Sanctus, 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 Domine Deus Sabaoth, benedicit in cielo terra gloria tua, Domine Jesus.
Benedictus tu in aeternum, Domine Jesus.
Sanctus, 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 sanct
soir, on peut se passer dans cette inconnue de tout suite et pas dans notre soir. Quand est-ce que vous avez besoin de Jésus-Christ? Salve Béatius, salve Jésus, 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 salve Nobis soque peccatoribus. Per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Oremus, precepti salutaribus moniti, et divina institutione formati, audemus dicere, Pater noster, qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittimus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem.
Salve nostra.
Per omnia saecula saeculorum. Pax Domini sit semper vobiscum. Miserato vestri omnipotens Deus et dimissis peccatis vestris, peccat vos ad vitam aeternam. Indulgentiam solutionem et remissionem peccatorum vestrorum. prebadovis omnipotens et misericors Dominus. Et chanus de et secutorit peccata mundi. Domine non sum dignus in tresto cum meum, setant unic verbo ut sinabitur anima mea. Domine non sum dignus in tresto cum meum, setant unic verbo ut sinabitur anima mea. Domine non sum dignus in tresto cum meum, setant unic verbo ut sinabitur anima mea.
Jesu Christi, così è tanto benedetta la mamma. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, così è tanto benedetta la mamma. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, così è tanto benedetta la mamma. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, così è tanto benedetta la mamma. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, così è tanto benedetta la mamma. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, così è tanto benedetta la mamma. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in vitata nam. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in vitata nam. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in vitata nam. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in vitata nam. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in vitata nam. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in vitata nam. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in vitata nam. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in vitata nam. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in vitata nam. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Amen. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Corpus Domus Jesu Christi, custodiat in tua vita eterna. Corpus Seigneur Jésus-Christ, Jésus-Christ, que ce soit notre éternel. Amen. Que ce soit Jésus-Christ, que ce soit notre éternel. Amen. Que ce soit Jésus-Christ, que ce soit notre éternel. Amen. Que ce soit Jésus-Christ, que ce soit notre éternel. Amen. Que ce soit Jésus-Christ, que ce soit notre éternel. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Vitam aeternam. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen. Corpus de Messie Jésus Christi, plus de l'être et de l'être. Amen.
Interjecta clamore meum in tene voci orationis mei, rex meus et Deus meus, coniam a teo rabo Domine. Dominus vobiscum. Oremus. Supplices te rogamus omnipotens Deus, ut quos tu irreficis sacramentis, divi etiam placitis moribus dignanter de servire concedas, per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum filium tuum, qui te convit et regnat mutatis spiritus sancti Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum. Dominus vobiscum. Ite missa est.
Deo gratias.
Benedicat vos omnipotens Deus. Pater et Filius et Spiritus Sanctus. Dominus vobiscum. Ministrum sancti evangelii secundum Ioannem. In principio erat verbum, et verbum erat ab Deum, et Deus erat verbum. Hoc erat in principio ab Deum. Omnia per ipsum facta sunt, et sine ipso factum est, nec id quod factum est. In ipso vita erat ex hominum, et lux in tenebris succet, et tenebra non comprenderunt. Fit omnem Iesus sola quod venerat Ioannem. Signet et est hominum, et est hominum per ibera del lumine, et omnes quadrant per illum. Non erat ille lux, et ut est hominum per ibera del lumine. Erat lux veraque, illuminat omnem omnia venentem in mundum. Il mondo erat et mundus per ipsum factus est et omnium non conivit. In propria venit et suum non receperunt. Quod quod totem receperunt eum dedit eis potestas tempus Deus ei fieri, et cucadunt. In eius, quod non ex omnibus, neque ex vontade carnis, neque ex viris, ex Deo nati sunt. Et verbum caro factum est, vita vitae novis, et vidimus gloriam eius, gloriam quasi unigintia patria, plenum gratia et veritatis. Ave Regina Caelorum.
Ave Domino Caelorum.
Salve Radix, salve Porta. Ex qua mundo lux est orta. Caude Virgo Gloriosa. Super omnes speciosa. Vale o valde de cor, et pro nobis Christum exora.
Oh,